Welcome, embedded engineers. This video is part of a tutorial series on developing web dashboards for embedded devices. In this episode, we will create a REST API on an embedded device to display the device state, specifically an uptime, free RAM, and the current version of the firmware. We will also learn how to display these parameters in the UI. In each episode, we use a different development board to demonstrate that Mongoose works across a wide range of hardware platforms. Today, we will be using the NXP MCXN947. Plug in the dev board to your workstation, connect it to Ethernet, and visit mongoose.ws. Click on the big blue button that takes you to the Mongoose Wizard, a visual dashboard builder. Start a new design from scratch. If you don't see this dialog, then click on the New button. Select target directory, where a generated project will be stored. Select target architecture, MCXN947, MCU Espresso IDE, and FreeRTOS. Click Next. Select the blank dashboard, click Next, and click Finish. Click on the REST API tab. So what is a REST API? A REST API is a collection of REST endpoints. Each endpoint is a specific URL that an HTTP client can call to communicate with the device. Click on Add API Endpoint. Mongoose offers different endpoint types, and today we'll focus on the data type. Rename the endpoint to State. The first attribute is created automatically. Rename it to Uptime. Set type to int and default value to 0. Add RAM free attribute of type int, default value 0. Add version attribute, type string, size 10, default value 1.0. Click on generated glue code to see the code that Wizard generates for this endpoint. And we can see that our endpoint has generated a C structure called state with three fields and two functions, a getter and a setter. The default implementation of these functions uses a mock variable that simulates the device state. Later, we will tell Mongoose to use our own handlers instead of these defaults. Set this endpoint to read-only. This disables the ability to modify values through the REST API. Notice that the setter function disappears. Click on Generate Code. Now, Wizard has created an MCU Espresso project with that blank dashboard in the target directory. Let's open it in the IDE. Start MCU Espresso. Import project. Navigate to the target directory. Here is our generated project. All network-related and web UI-related files are in the Mongoose directory. Build the project. Start the serial console to see the logs. Now flash it. Look at the logs to find the board's IP address. Load it in the browser. And here we go. This is the same dashboard we saw in the wizard, now served by the device. Our dashboard is blank, but we have added the API endpoint called state, so we can call it. We can use the curl utility to test it. Start another terminal and run curl device's IP address and the URL /API/state. We can see the response, and this response has been generated by the default handler function located in mongoose-glue.c. Now we can create our own handler for that API. Let's copy the default implementation to main.c and rename it to myGetState. Remove the mock variable. We must populate the data structure with the real values. Set the uptime to mg/millis divided by 1000. mg/millis returns the number of milliseconds since boot. So dividing by 1000 would report the number of seconds since boot. Set RAM free to export get free heap size, which is a FreeRTOS API function. and set the firmware version. Let's make a define for it that is easy to change. Tell Mongoose to use our handler instead of a default ones. Call Mongoose set HTTP handlers for the API endpoint state. Our getter is my get state, and the setter is null, because the API endpoint is read-only. Rebuild the firmware and reflash it. Run curl again. Notice the response has changed. Now Mongoose uses our handler, which is tied to our hardware. Now let's display those values on our dashboard. Click on UI elements, add a container, add a text element, and type version and state.version. Mongoose will expand expressions inside curly brackets with actual API values. This way we can display any API value. There is a predefined element for displaying devices metrics. Let's use it. Delete this container and add a stats row element. We can add or delete individual cards if required. Let's make the first card to show uptime. Change the title and set the variable expression to state.uptime. The second card will show the free RAM. Change the title and set the variable reference to state.ramFree. And the third card will show firmware version. Change the title and set the variable reference to state.version. Now we should copy over our changes to the MCU Espresso project. Click on Settings and change the integration mode to existing project. Click on Generate Code. Rebuild and reflash the project. Refresh the browser and notice that our dashboard displays the values reported by our device. Congratulations! We have learned how to create API endpoints on our device, attach custom handlers to them, call these API handlers remotely, and display values on a dashboard. Note that instead of using curl, a remote automation software may query your device periodically and collect health information. This is an easy way to implement remote monitoring. Hit like and subscribe if you found this useful. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.